First Warn 5 weather with Pat Holliner.
6:42 this morning, and in some parts of the country, the weather's quieted down, like the Northeast. Pretty quiet conditions temporarily. The front has drifted a little bit farther to the south. I do want to point out the rain that's still ongoing in the southeast. Now, we're really not concerned about flash flooding for now, but any rain they're getting now is not a good thing because that's just making the soil even wetter. You're hearing about that, the sinkhole issue in Florida, too, because they've already seen a lot of rain, and there's only more rain coming for Memorial Day weekend. That is going to be a big story, a significant flash flood risk across the southeast for Memorial Day weekend. Meanwhile, we're going to be struggling to see any rain after the next couple days. There are some small chances today and tomorrow, but then it's going to be completely dry. It could be completely dry, honestly, looking at long range models, perhaps through the first week of June and staying with above normal temperatures. So not what we want to hear with the ongoing drought situation. This morning, a few showers in the lower valley along the coast. We're already seeing a few of those drift inland, and I think we will continue until about maybe 9 a.m. or so. Then those go away, but new showers start to develop perhaps as early as noon, as you'll see here. Again, probably starting in the lower valley like we saw yesterday and then drifting on into the upper valley. It's those sea breeze showers. We've seen them the last couple days. I think we're going to see them again today. A lot of people staying dry, but a few may catch a little bit of light rain. There's an outside chance, maybe a clap of thunder, but most of the time these tend to just be pretty light rain that comes down. And then I do think eventually we'll have mostly sunny skies as we get into the late afternoon, early evening hours. Much of the night is going to be mostly clear. I think tomorrow we have a better chance at fog forming because I think we're going to be mostly clear for a longer period of time, and the winds are going to be light for a longer period of time. So light fog in more spots than what we've seen the last couple of days. I still don't think it's going to be dense, maybe in a couple spots, but a little bit of fog to start the day tomorrow. In general, tomorrow is going to be pretty similar today. Partly cloudy skies for much of the day with a few sea breeze showers. One more chance at seeing some in the afternoon tomorrow. They all go away by the early evening hours. Mostly sunny skies, and get ready to hear a lot of mostly sunny in the forecast. It looks very dry for Memorial Day weekend and very hot. Already hot today, 94, but with the humidity that's so high, it's going to feel more like 99 because there's not even going to be much of a breeze to help us out. Only a 10 mile per hour wind. And at 20% chance of showers overall, that means 80% of us are going to stay dry, but maybe you'll get lucky and get a little bit of light rain. At this point, we're kind of hoping for the rain. Most of the day is just going to be partly cloudy. Tonight, it's mainly going to be mostly clear, but very late tonight, some of that fog will set up, mainly light, maybe dense at a couple spots, but for most of us, just a little light fog early tomorrow morning. Let's talk about the Memorial Day weekend forecast. 97 on Saturday, 98 on Sunday, 100. Yes, forecasting 100 for Memorial Day. And also focusing on that heat index, it's going to feel like 102 Saturday and Sunday and 104 on Monday. A whole bunch of sun. At least there's a breeze on Sunday. Now that's about the only positive to help us cool us down. And if you want to know what beyond Monday looks like, not still another day with 100 degrees, feeling like the mid 100s, and still 99 on Wednesday, the breeze kicks back in. But honestly, it looks like we are going to stay in the mid to upper 90s, probably into next weekend as well.